Okay, so we'll continue with French Revolution, Chapter 1 of History, and what we had seen till now. On 14 July 1789, the government buildings were attacked by the people because the people had heard rumors that the king is going to order his troops to fire on the people, attack the people, kill the people. And because of that, the people got together, they formed a military, that is, of people, that is known as people's militia, in order to face or fight against the troops of the king. And with this, the revolution started, the French Revolution. They went into Bastille, the fortress prison, they attacked it, they demolished it, 7 prisoners were there, they were rescued. All this happened, and even you had seen that the remains of this prison were sold in the market for the people to buy and keep as a souvenir in their house. People were, and then we went into the flashback in order to find out why this happened, why the French Revolution took place, why it happened. We went to find out this, and then we started with the structure of the society, and we had seen that the French society was divided into 3 estates: first estate, second estate, and the third estate. The first estate, including the clergy, as it is written here, second estate, nobility, and the third, the remaining ones, clergy, church, priests, and all come in clergy. Nobility, the royal family, royalty, the aristocrats, the high class people, they come in nobility. And whoever is remaining, they all form the third estate. Now, we also found that the first and the second estate, they enjoyed a very nice life. They enjoyed many privileges by birth. They didn't have to pay any type of taxes. The third estate served them. All the burden of taxes, all the burden of running the country was on the third estate, because the money required by the king to run the country, to maintain the army, to maintain the court, everything was taken as tax from the people. 2 types of taxes we had talked about times. That was the tax taken by the government, and it is that was the tax taken by the church. All right, and we had also talked about subsistence crisis, that the condition of France was deteriorating as the population was increasing, food grain was short, and because of that, prices of things kept on rising, and people did not have that much money to buy these things of daily need, and because of that, people were very angry, and That is also a reason because of which people revolted against the king, and the French Revolution started. So we'll start with page number 6. A growing middle class envisages an end to privileges. In the past, peasants and workers had participated in revolts against increasing taxes and food scarcity, but they lacked the means and programs to carry out full-scale measures that would bring about a change in social and economic order. This was left to those groups within the third estate who had become prosperous and had access to education and new ideas. Now, what had happened? What had happened? The people of the third estate had raised their voice against rise of price and food shortage and all earlier also. They had revolted earlier also. But what had happened is that at that time, there was no one to lead them. They did not have the right direction how to carry on with the revolt, how to carry on with the revolution, what to do. That was left over to the educated, the prosperous, the people who had money. The third estate, I told you, consisted of businessmen, merchants, and then laborers and artisans and also. There were some rich people also, very prosperous people also. There were professionals also, educated people. So these rich people and the educated people, it was their duty to guide the people of the third estate to revolt against the government, to raise their voice for their rights. They guided them. The 18th century witnessed the emergence of social groups termed the middle class, who earned their wealth through an expanding overseas trade and from the manufacture of goods such as woolen and silk textiles that were either exported or brought by the richer members of the society. So 18th century industrialization had started. So many people of the third estate, they had become wealthy by overseas trade and manufacture of textile goods. In addition to merchants and manufacturers, the third estate included professionals such as lawyers and administrative officials. So already you had merchants and manufacturers, they were rich people. Other than that, you had lawyers, you had other officials working under the government, they all formed. So they were literate people, they were people who had money, so they could guide the other people what is to be done. All of these were educated and believed that no group in society should be privileged by birth. This is to be underlined. All right, all these people of the third estate, they believed that privileges should not be given to people by birth, but people should earn the privilege through merit. They should be worthy of it. All right, a person becomes a king because he is born in a royal family, or he is the son of the former king. Maybe he doesn't know how to rule, so he is not eligible. So that is what they said, that privileges by birth should not be there, rather your position in the society, you should earn that position by merit. These ideas, envisaging a society based on freedom and equal laws and opportunities for all, were put forward by philosophers such as John Locke and Jean-Jacques Rousseau. So John Locke, Jean-Jacques Rousseau, they all put this idea in front of the people that the government should be such, or a country should be such, where there should be freedom to all the people and everyone should be equal before law. Some students, the video is not on. Put on your video. Am I audible to everyone? Once again, thumbs up. Section A and B, am I audible? All right, good. So John Locke had written this book, Two Treatises of Government. All right, it is a written work where he had said that what the government should be doing. He had given all the points, how the government should function, what the government should do for the people. In this book, he had said to refute the doctrine of the divine and absolute right of the monarch. And he has said that we have to form a government where government works for the people, and the government or the monarch is not divine, he is not godly, he is not like God, where whatever he says, people have to listen. Actually, this was the belief. The king is in place of God, and you have to give him that much respect, and whatever he says has to be done. Rousseau carried the idea forward, proposing a form of government based on a social contract between people and their representatives. So Rousseau, he carried this idea forward, and he said that there should be a contract, an understanding, an agreement between the people and the representative of the people. The representative should form the government, and there should be an understanding and agreement between the people and their representatives. In the Spirit of the Laws, this is another book written by Montesquieu, proposed a division of power within the government between the legislative, the executive and the judiciary. He said that the government's power should be divided between judiciary, executive and legislature. It should be divided. In a monarchical government, what happens? All the power is concentrated in one person's hand. One person decides everything, whatever he feels like. But he said, or this was said, that it should not be like that. Montesquieu said the power should be divided. It should be divided between judiciary, executive and legislature. This model of government was put into force in USA after the 13 colonies declared their independence from Britain. You know, the 13 states of USA were fighting against Britain for independence. Finally, when they got independence, they formed the United States of America, and there they were following this model of government, which was explained in the Spirit of Laws by Montesquieu. The American Constitution and its guarantee of individual rights was an important example for political thinkers in France. So American independence and the way the government was working in America, every individual, every person had his rights, human right, that was given to every person. That was a model, that was something which all philosophers liked, and they wanted this type of governance, this type of thinking to spread everywhere in the world. The ideas of these philosophers were discussed intensively in salons and coffee houses and spread among people through books and newspapers. These frequently read aloud in groups for the benefit of those who could not read and write. So these were the ideas of the people. 1 minute. Okay, so these ideas of the philosophers, people used to discuss about it. Wherever they gathered, they used to discuss. And in books and newspapers also it came. Many times when there is a group of people sitting, someone would stand and read it aloud so that everyone should come to know what are these ideas. The news that Louis XVI planned to impose further taxes to be able to meet the expenses of the state generated anger and protest against the system of privileges. And people also got this news that Louis XVI is planning to put the burden of tax, more tax on the people. He is going to increase tax on the people. And if he increases tax, this will be a great problem for the people, because already they are suffering, already they don't have money, the price of things is already rising, how they are going to manage. So people were very angry and they were ready to protest against the system of privileges, that why only the third estate has to pay the taxes, why only the third estate, why not others also pay the taxes. This feeling started coming in the people. I hope it is clear till here. The outbreak of revolution, page number 8, the outbreak of revolution. Louis XVI had to increase taxes for reasons we have learned in the previous section. You already know, when he became the king, he took over as the king, the treasury was empty. Now he has to maintain army, he has to run the government, he has to maintain the rich court, maintain his royal life. For all these things he required money. From where to bring this money? So for that, he requires to increase taxes. How do you think he could have gone about doing this? Now, how to increase tax? What was the system of increasing tax in France? In France of the old regime, the monarch did not have the power to impose taxes according to his will alone. Now, king wants money. So he cannot say, okay, from tomorrow I am going to increase the tax. No. He cannot take a decision alone. All right. Rather, he had to call a meeting of the Estates General, which would then pass his proposal for new taxes. So he had to call a meeting of the Estates General. Members of the first estate, members of the second estate, and members of the third estate. That is the Estates General. Representatives from all these three estates would come and there would be a meeting. And in that meeting, the decision would be taken. The Estates General was a political body to which the three estates sent their representatives. However, the monarch alone could decide when to call a meeting of this body. So, I told you, Estates General means a meeting of the representatives of all the three estates. The decision when a meeting is to be called is taken only by the king. The last time it was done was in 1614. All right. So you can imagine, more than 170 years after that, now again it is being done. The meeting is being done about 175 years. On 5th May 1789, Louis XVI called together an assembly of Estates General to pass proposal for new taxes. So now he called the meeting. Now you tell me, first estate they don't pay taxes, second estate they don't pay taxes. Taxes are paid only by the third estate. So first estate is also not worried, second estate is also not worried. Let the king increase as much as he wants to increase the tax, because they don't have to pay. Only the people of the third estate, the members of the third estate, they are worried. What is happening? A resplendent hall, that is a very attractive and colorful hall in the Versailles, was prepared to host the delegates. The first and second estates sent 300 representatives each, who were seated in rows facing each other on two sides. They were given chairs to sit, place to sit, and they sat in front of one another, first estate and second estate. They were sitting, all right, 300 from both the estates. The third estate was represented by its, okay, while the 600 members of the third estate had to stand at the back. Third estate people were not even given place to sit. They had to stand behind the people of first estate and second estate. Peasants, artisans and women were denied entry to the assembly. They were not allowed. Only the rich, all right, educated people of the third estate were allowed to come for this meeting. Women were not allowed. The peasants, the laborers, the artisans, skilled craftsmen, they were not allowed to come. However, the grievances and demands were listed in some 40,000 letters which the representatives had brought with them. But whatever problems they had, whatever things they wanted, they could write and give it to the representatives who were going for the meeting. So that way about 40,000 letters were there, sent by the people, their problems to be discussed during the meeting of the estates general. Alright, so the meeting of the estates general is going to start to decide about increasing taxes. So in the next class we'll see how this meeting went on and what happened. Alright, so we'll continue in the next class. Till then, bye from me to all. Thank you for attending the class.